Hello students, in this lesson, let us study about the airport capacity. So we'll exactly see what is airport capacity and see what are the factors that will affect the airport operating capacity. So to get started with, normally your aircraft will have two movements, right? Two movements. What are those? One is the takeoff and the other one is the landing. Normally, your landing is given more priority when compared to your takeoff. The term airport capacity is used to indicate the aircraft movements which an airport can permit within a specified period of time by allowing capable time of delay to the departing aircrafts. Okay, it is used to indicate the aircraft movement. The movement can be both takeoff as well as landing, which an airport can permit within a specified period of time by allowing acceptable time of delay to the departing aircraft. So there will be lot of departing aircrafts and lot of aircrafts which will be landing. So the airport capacity is designed in such a way at a particular instant of time or a period of time, however many aircrafts are departing, even considering the delay of the depart, you can even accommodate the landing of the other aircrafts, which is designed for the entire system. So that exactly is the airport capacity. Now this is influenced by many number of factors, the major and the important one being the spacing between successive aircraft. Normally, whatever will be the ideal airport capacity, it is reduced to some extent by your practical consideration. So normally what we have to do, we have to design a little higher. So when it comes to practical consideration, it will get reduced. So your practical operating capacity is less than the ideal or theoretical capacity. Now let us see what are the major factors that will affect your airport capacity. So the first one is the arrangement, size and number of gates in the apron area. Then the availability and structure of the airspace. How much of airspace is available? That is also a very important factor that will influence your airport capacity. Next one is, what are the characteristics of the aircraft which is coming to those particular airport? That will also influence your airport capacity. So characteristics of the aircraft using the airport. Then is your configuration, that is how the structure is made. Then number is how many numbers are there, and location, where exactly is the location of the taxiway as well as runway. Fifth one is again configuration, number, spacing will come here, that is distance between two runways, and the orientation, how exactly in what angle is your runway oriented, that also it will depend on, of the runway system. The entire runway system will come into consideration now. The next one is the existence and nature of the navigational aids. What all navigational aids are there? Based on that also, the capacity of your runway will be, capacity of your airport will be decided. Okay. Then on the nature and extent of what all air traffic control facilities are there, based on that also your airport capacity will depend. Aircraft traffic control facilities. Then the number of, as well as the frequency of touch and go operations. What do you mean by touch and go operations? Nothing but the aircrafts which will come, land, finish the work fast and immediately take off. Right, that type of operations are called as touch and go operations. So based on how many touch and go operations are there, we will have to decide the airport capacity. Then how many number of arrivals are there in the airport when compared to your number of departures, that also will have an influence. Then based on the techniques which we use for controlling the airway runway system, as well as the operation of the airway runway system, the airport capacity will depend. Techniques adopted by the controller and operate the airway runway system. Then the last one is your weather condition, wind condition, visibility condition, on all this also the capacity of the airport will vary. So we have to take care of all the 11 things before we decide what should be the airport capacity. How much of aircrafts are coming in and how much of aircrafts are moving away. Hope this lesson is clear to you now. Thank you.